We heard about the history of the Hindu festivals, but do you think they've lost all their religious meaning nowadays?
Yes. You see, one of the important things when you explore festivals of any religion is to see what we do, when we do, what is the basis to it. Say, okay, it's got historic foundation or mythological foundation. It's got seasonal aspect. It may be talking about relationship. That's all fine. But if you forget to ask the question why we celebrate any festival whatsoever, if you lose sight of that, then a society evolves, as you evolve, sometimes these celebrations become purely mechanical and lose all its meaning. There's a real danger. So whenever I teach Hinduism, I tell people, look, it's good for you to know why you're celebrating Diwali, but you must ask the question, why? Why do we do any activity in the name of religion, including celebrating festivals? If you focus on the why element, then when society evolves, you can then adjust your festival to kind of, you know, follow the requirement of the society, evolving society. But if you don't know the why, you can't change. You are stuck in a rut. And the festivals can become counterproductive. For example, the Diwali festival is nowadays, rather than say, oh, let's think about Ram, who was this great, marvelous hero, lived for principles, ideals, you know, what a marvelous... Rather than do that, we turn into a party time. So festivals become nothing but time to party, feasting and fireworks. I'm not criticizing, I'm simply saying, have your feasting, have your fireworks, but do not forget to focus on why this individual is so crucial for India, for Hindus, and why we should continue to aspire to the same goals that he was aspiring for, living for higher ideals. So if we lose track of that, then the celebration becomes purely mechanical and has lost its meaning. So you must realize why we celebrate. We say we celebrate because we want to try and focus on this personality and what it stood for. You see, you must remember the why part. All festivals, all ritualistic aspect of every religion must answer the question, why? Why do you do worship in the morning? Why do you go to the temple? Why do you go on pilgrimage? Why do you celebrate festivals? There are certain lovely key answers to all these questions. And I'll just give you a short version of it. One is to try and see if you can put religion into our daily life. So if you've got a festival once a year or this, at least in that particular period of time, you can think of higher things. So it's a reminder. Second, the reason why we celebrate is because it's got a symbolic significance, like the story of Ram, symbolic, aspiring for higher ideals. So it's got a symbolic aspect. The other aspect of celebrating any or kind of carrying out any ritual is because it says, in a way, it allows you to relate to a higher ideal, if you like, in your daily routine. Otherwise, life passes by very fast. And finally, we say we carry out any activity because it will produce beneficial results in the long term. When you repeat, suppose you meditate every day, and that ritual you carry out day in, day out, that discipline that you put in will produce, give you beneficial results in days to come. So it's a discipline. Festivals are a discipline. On the days of festivals, a lot of people fast for the whole day. So you impose a discipline on yourself to say, I'm more than animal, I can control my bodily requirements. So the festivals got all this kind of ritual aspect has got many reasons why. You must focus on the why aspect, and that will really help you, benefit you a great deal. If you don't know the why part, they can become negative.